फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ऑलू बोर्ड। आई एम योर क्वांट फैकल्टी प्रियंका हियर। सो फ्रेंड्स, वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन परम्यूटेशन एंड कॉम्बिनेशन। नाउ द थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ द टॉपिक इज नथिंग बट बाइनोमियल थ्योरम। यू नो, फ्रॉम दिस टॉपिक ऑल्सो यू मे गेट क्वेश्चन, वन और टू क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन दिस टॉपिक। ओके, सो फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ बाइनोमियल, देन वी विल डिस्कस द बाइनोमियल थ्योरम एंड देन द टाइप्स ऑफ क्वेश्चन दैट कैन बी आस्क फ्रॉम दिस टॉपिक। सो फ्रेंड्स, लेट्स बिगिन दिस टॉपिक। So first, let me explain you what is the meaning of binomial. Okay, so any algebraic expression which is having two terms is called as the binomial expression over here. Now you have any type of expression. For example, see x plus 5. This is one term. This is second term. So there are two terms over here. So I'll call this as a binomial. Similarly, here also this is one term. This is also one term. Okay, now x and y are variable. I'm not talking about that. I'm just discussing the term over here. Term means the addition, between the addition, whatever values are written, those all are the terms. So this is first term, this is second term. Similarly, this is also binomial. Yes, I hope all of you must have understood the meaning of binomial expression over here. Now, all of us know that suppose if I want to write x to the power 5 to the power 2, what will you say? A plus B whole square. So we know how to expand this. We will write this as x square plus 2 into 5 into x, right? And last one is 5 square, that is 25. So this is how we expand it, that is x square plus 10x plus 25. So very easily you could expand it, right? Now suppose if I give you x plus 5 to the power 10. Now how will you do this? For this, you need to know the formula. Now, how this formula is generated, that is what is told using the binomial theorem over here. So, binomial theorem will give me generalized expression for x plus any value a or any two terms over here, not only x. You may have any ax and bx term over here, by and to the power n. So, for this, they will be giving you expression through the binomial theorem. So, let us discuss that in detail in the further slides. So, before we start with that, let me explain you a few small concepts. So here, this is called as the Pascal triangle. I'll tell you what is the meaning of Pascal triangle. First, let us see the expansion of a plus b to the power 0. This is nothing but 1. This we already know, right? Now, a plus b to the power 1, this is written as a to the power 1 plus b to the power 1. Similarly, I have just given you the formula for a plus b whole square. How we express it? We write it as a square plus 2ab plus b square, right? So this is how we are expanding. Now, if I give you a to the power a plus b to the power 3, this formula is also known to us. But when we are talking about a plus b to the power 4, these all are the coefficient. 1, this is 4, 6, 4, and this is 1. Okay, so what are the coefficient? 1, 4, 6, 4, 1. So these coefficients are given using the Pascal triangle over here. Can you observe this? This is 1. Yes, so that is what is written over here. So this is again 1 and 1. Now, how will you get third line? You have to write this one as it is. Add these two values. Write it over here. This one is copied as it is. Similarly, 1 here. Again, 1 plus 2, 3. 1 plus 2, 3. 1 as it is. Similarly, 1, 4, 6, 4, 1. Are you getting it? To write the coefficient, this is how we verify the value. Okay. Now, but this is not the way we are going to get any expression. For example, if I ask you x plus a plus b to the power 10, you cannot write this, okay? So this is just for your verification that if I give you any term, you can tell me the coefficient from this. Okay, now there are few observations which I wanted to make from the above expression over here. So please pay attention. Now when I'm saying the index is 0, the total number of terms in the expression are 1. Okay, now where index is 1, number of terms here are 2. Similarly, when index is 2, how many terms are there? 3 terms. So, can I say that first observation, number of terms is nothing but n plus 1. Whatever index is given, you have to add 1 with that. I hope all of you are getting it. So, whenever your power is n, n plus 1 terms would be there. I hope all of you are following. The next thing we will observe over here is, let me observe the a over here. So, a index was 2 over here. It was maximum. The first term index is maximum over here and it is decreasing. This is becoming a to the power 1 and I can write this as a to the power 0. Now observe this. I can write this as b to the power 0, a to the power 3. Second term a to the power 2 and b. I am not writing the coefficient. I am just writing a and b over here. Next one a, b square and last one b to the power 3 means a to the power 0. right? So that means A power is increasing and B power, sorry, B power is increasing and A power is decreasing over here, okay? So A value is maximum at the start and it will keep on going to zero, okay? And second one, if you observe here, B value is zero at the start and it will become maximum at the end. So this is how the progress of A and B happens over here. I hope all of you are getting it. Now, then we also can observe over here, at each of the term, if you add the indices, the index will be equal to overall index over here. So for each term, first term, if I observe 3 plus 0, it is 3. 2 plus 1 means it is 3. 1 plus 2 means it is 3. And last 0 plus 3 means it is 3. Similarly, here power is 4. Can you observe this is 4? This is 3 plus 1, 4. 2 plus 2, 4. Are you getting it? So can I say each term will be having index of n over here. Each term will have index of n over here. Whatever the expression is given, that is given in your expression. Okay, fourth term you have to observe is each expression starts with the coefficient of 1. Because you can observe the initial coefficient is 1. Last coefficient is always 1. The middle values are keep on changing. Are you getting it? So last observation is, first and last coefficient are always 1 over here. Okay, so first and last coefficient value should always be 1. Okay, now there has to be some formula how I am getting this. So all of you just pay attention over here. Now whenever I have to calculate this value, it is given using a binomial expression over here. Now what is a binomial expression for this? Let me first explain this to you. So when we are talking about this, I will explain the terms using this Pascal triangle now. So whenever you are expressing any term over here, it is represented as NCR. Okay, so when you are writing any term, it is represented as NCR over here. And first term to the power N minus R and B to the power R. Okay, so this is how each term in the binomial is expressed over here. So let me explain it to you. For example, suppose if I am talking about A plus B to the power N. Now simply what I told you, initially coefficient would be 1 and highest power of A would be there. So it will be A plus A to the power N. Now when you are talking about the second term, you will be getting some coefficient, right? But the power of A will decrease. So it will become N minus 1. B to the power 1. The total should remain n over here. Right? So next term when you are talking about A to the power n minus 2, B to the power 2. Likewise, you have to increase the value of B, decrease the value of n. So last one would be 1B to the power n over here. Are you getting it? There are total n plus 1 terms over here. I hope all of you are getting it. Now how we get this coefficient? For example, now let me tell you these all coefficients are calculated using NCR. Okay, so first term when I'm talking about it is NC0. Okay, when I'm talking about second one, it is NC1. When I'm talking about the second term, it is NC1. When third term, it is NC2. So please remember, whatever value you are writing, you have to change it accordingly. For example, here I will be writing the power is 1, so I'll be writing 1C0. Can you observe this? 1C0 is nothing but 1. Now let me observe this over here. Yes. So here you have written 1 and 1. So here index value was 1 over here. Right. So whatever n value I am writing, let me express it over here itself. So let me erase all the part. So what I am saying is, you just observe the index is 0 over here. So let me write down 0C0. Okay. Because I am talking about the first term. So whenever you are writing the value over here, that is 1. Now let me take this is 1C0, that is my first term which is 1, next is 1C1, so again that is 1 over here. Let me take second over here, okay, so first term if I am observing this is 2C0, 2C0 value is 1, right? What is this value? When you are writing the second coefficient, it is 2C1. When you are writing the third coefficient, it is 2C2. Now you know this is 1 and this value is 2 over here. Are you getting my point? Now here you have to note one thing. You have to write the coefficient using NCR. But if you observe, this R value is 1 less over here. So when I'm talking about the first term, it is 0. When I'm talking about the second term, it is 1. Are you getting it? So can I say that when I'm talking about any general term TR plus 1, Okay, well, whenever I'm talking about nr plus 1, my formula will become ncr. When I'm talking about second term, it is 1, right? When I'm talking about third term, it is 2. Because you are decreasing it by one value because you're starting with 0 over here. Right? Total number of terms are n plus 1. So I have to start with 0 and end with n over here. So the 0 is making this change over here. So please remember, first term will have 0, means 1 reduced. The same thing I'm writing over here. Ncr. And when I'm talking about the first term, it is written as n minus r. And second term is written as b to the power r. Now this formula is very, very important for you to calculate any value. Now let me explain it over here. So when I'm expressing these values, you can just erase all this part. Now suppose if I ask you in the expression, suppose if generally I have to calculate, suppose if I give you a plus b to the power 4, or let me take 5. Okay, and if I'm asking you calculate the t5 term value over here. T5. Now I just now gave you formula tr plus 1. This is written as ncr. Yes. First term would be a to the power n minus r, and second term would be b to the power r. Now here I am talking about t5, and this is my expression. So n value will be 5 over here. What will you write? This is 5c, and now I want fifth term over here. Now just now I told you it is r plus 1. So can I say r plus 1 is equal to 5? So r will become 4 over here. So what will you write? 5c4 a to the power 5 minus 4 and b to the power 4 over here. Can you observe this? Now if you calculate this coefficient, this 5c4 value. Now 5c4 is also important over here. When you are calculating this value, I have explained this in the permutation and combination. This can also be written as 5c5 minus 4, that is 1. And how we calculate this value? 5 is written only 1 times, divided by this factorial. So 1 factorial is 1. That means I'm getting 5 as the coefficient. Are you getting it? Now can we check it using Pascal triangle? See, we are talking about a plus b to the power 5. This is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So I'm talking about this expression. Which term are you talking about? Fifth term over here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Can you observe it? 5 is the coefficient. That is what you got over here. I hope it is clear. This is how you have to calculate the expression. Okay, I hope it is clear, but let me explain one more term over here so it will become more clear to you. Okay, now let us take next example. Suppose if I give you a plus b to the power 6 and if I am asking you calculate the coefficient of t4. Okay, calculate the coefficient of t4. Now you know that this is r plus 1. So my r value would be 3. Okay, now calculate the value 6c3. NCR, right? First term to the power n minus r, 6 minus 3, and second term to the power 3. I hope it is clear. Now you can calculate what is this value, 6 into 5 into 4. Remember, you have to count this for these many numbers divided by this factorial. What is 3 factorial? It is 6. So the 6 will get cancelled over here. What are you getting? 20. Yes, we are getting 20 over here. Now just now I told you this is 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and this is 6 over here. We are talking about fourth term. 1, 2, 3, 4. Can you observe? You are getting 20 as the coefficient. Okay, so this Pascal triangle you cannot every time form. So this is the way we are going to calculate coefficient of any term in the given example. I hope all of you are getting it. So based on this, I want you to remember few points. Number of terms in the expression. Okay, number of terms are always given by n plus 1. Okay, so based on this, many times question could be there in your exam. In this expression, you are going to have 7 terms over here. When your value was 0, there was 1 term. When term was 1, there were 2 terms. Okay, number of terms would be this value. Okay, then next value you have to remember is tr plus 1. That formula will be very, very important. Ncr. A to the power n minus r and b to the power r over here. I hope all of you are getting it. Based on these 2 points, many times questions are asked in your exam. Now let me move on to the question directly. So here is what I have written, the binomial expansion. So just now whatever I have explained you, that is nothing but the binomial expansion over here. This is given by binomial theorem. Okay, so how it is written? When I am talking about x plus y to the power n, This is NC0, first term. Okay, x to the power n, the maximum value of x over here, and here maximum value of y. Okay, so x value will keep on decreasing, n minus 1, n minus 2. Y value will keep on increasing. So here it is 1, here it is 2, till n it will go. You know all this, number of terms would be n plus 1. And how we write the general term? NCR x to the power r, this is TR plus 1. Okay, so this R plus 1 is very, very important. So I hope it is clear. Now let me give one example so that it will become more clear to you. So let us expand this expression which is there on your screen. X square plus 3 by x to the power 4. Now how many terms would be there? If I'm talking about the terms, there would be 5 terms. Okay, now exactly this type of question will not be there in exam, but using this, your concept of expansion will become more clear over here. So what will you write for first term? 4c0, first term to the power, maximum power over here. Okay, let me write the second term, 4c1. Now here x square, the power will reduce by 1, and second term power would be 1 over here. Getting it? When you are talking about the second term, 4c2, what will you write for x square? X square to the power 2 and 3 by x to the power 2 again, because this is increasing by 1. Okay, next term let me write 4c3. What will you write over here? X square to the power 1, because this is decreasing now, and next term will become 3 by x cube over here. How many terms I have written? 1, 2, 3, 4. One more term would be there. Last term, that is 4c4. Now here this power will become 0. Only 3 by x will come over here as 4. Getting it? Yes. So this is how you have to expand it. Now 4c0 is 1. So what will you write for this? X to the power 8. 4c1 is 4. Right? X square to the power 3. So a to the power m to the power n. You have to multiply these two coefficients. So x to the power 6, and here you have 3 as well divided by this x over here. So what is this total term? 12x to the power 5. When it goes in the numerator, 6 minus 1 happens. Okay, that is the indices rule. So we'll be getting 12x to the power 5. Let us evaluate next term. What will you write for this? 4 into 3 divided by 2. This is nothing but 6. Okay, here I have x to the power 4. Here I have 9. Upon x square over here. If I am calculating the coefficient, what will you get over here? 3 2s are 6, 6 9s are 54. So 54, and this x power will become 4 minus 2, that is 2 over here. Getting it? Now 4c3, you know this rule. This can be written as 4c4 minus 3, that is 4c1 over here. Okay, so I can write this value as 4. This x square to the power 1 means x square. 3 cube means 27 upon x cube. So what value you will get? 4 into 27. So I can directly write down the value over here. 108. Right? And this x square will go in denominator now, and I will have only x. Okay? And last value is 4c4. You know this value is 1 upon 3 to the power 4 means 81 upon x to the power 4. So last term would be 81. Upon x to the power 4. First term is x to the power 8. So this is how you have to expand it. I think you must have understood how to apply the binomial expression in any question. Okay. Now let me discuss the question that can be asked in your exam. So here this is the type of question that comes in your exam. They have given you find the coefficient of x to the power 6, y to the power 3 in the expansion over here. Now for this you have to write down the general term. Okay, now TR plus 1 is there. This is written as NCR. Now, what is the first expression? This is x. First term is x to the power n minus r. And second term is 2y. So, 2y to the power r. Okay, expand this. What will you get? NCR. This is x to the power n minus r. And this value you can keep as it is. Okay, before we write anything, you just observe what do you want over here. So, I want this value to be 6. X power to be 6 over here. Now n value is 9. So total of 6 plus 3 is 9. That is what is given. Right? It is verified. This term addition should be 9 over here. So I want this value. N value is 9. R value is 6. R value is 6. Because n minus, sorry, not R value. R value I have to calculate. The n minus R total value is given to you as 6. Okay, not R. N minus R value is 6 over here. So can we write it? 9 minus r equal to 6 or r equal to 3 over here. So you have to calculate r3. That means I can say t4 over here. Getting it? t4, so you can write t4 over here. Write down the formula now. ncr, so 9c3. 9cr value is 3 over here. The second value will become 9 minus 3, that is 6, right? And this value you can write down 2y to the power 3. Okay, so what are you getting? You can calculate this coefficient 9 into 8 into 7. Count this for the 3 number. Write the factorial of this. What is the factorial of this? 6, right? And this is x to the power 6. This is 8 over here into y cube. I hope all of you are getting it. So you can calculate the value. 3 2s are 3, 3s are, right? This is 2 4s are. So you can calculate what value you are getting over here. 4 3s are 12, 12 7s are 84 into 8. So you can calculate what would be the coefficient in this case. So 672 would be the coefficient in this case. So that is what can come in your exam. We will solve few more questions. Find the coefficient of x to the power 5 in the expression. Okay. So let me write down tr plus 1. N value is 8 over here. So 8cr, okay, x to the power n minus r. So 8 minus r, and 3 is my second term. So 3 to the power r. Now what do you want? X to the power 5 means 8 minus r should be equal to 5. So what value you are getting for r? R will be equal to 3. Now you can evaluate what would be the coefficient over here. So can I write t4? This is nothing but 8c3. This value is nothing but x to the power 5, okay, and 3 to the power 3 over here, 3 to the power 3. You can calculate what you are getting. 8 into 7 into 6 divided by 3 factorial. So 3 factorial, I am directly writing 6. This 3 to the power 3 is nothing but 27. You can cancel this and calculate what value you are getting in this case. Okay, so 8 7s are, you can calculate 56 over here. 56 into 27, you can calculate the value. So this is 56 into 27, that is nothing but 1512. I hope it is clear. So this is how you have to calculate any coefficient which is asked in your exam. Now let me take one example which was asked so that it will become more clear to you. Here what is asked now? What is the coefficient of x to the power 17 in this expansion? Again, write down the same value. tr plus 1, 9cr. Now what is first term? 3x. You have to be very careful. 3x to the power 9 minus r. Second term is this complete negative value. Whenever you have negative term, you have to take that sign as well. This will become r. Now calculate what is x power over here. I'm just talking about x power, okay? X to the power 9 minus r is there, right? What about this? X to the power, if you are evaluating 3 into r, so it will become 3r. So what is this total power? X to the power 9 plus 2r. Because you have to add these two terms. So 9 minus r plus 3r. So it will become 9 plus 2r. What I want over here, this value should be 17. So 9 plus 2r value is 17 over here. You can write down 2r is equal to 8, r is equal to 4. So easily I can see what would be the coefficient now. So 9c4. Okay. Second term you are writing 3x, 9 minus 4 is 5. Okay, next value you can write down minus x cube by 6 to the power r, that is 4. Now evaluate this value. What would be the value? 9, 8, 7 into 6 divided by this is 4, 3, 2 into 1. What is 3 to the power 5? 3 to the power 5, you can write this as 3 to the power 3 into 3 to the power 2. Right? 3 to the power 3 is 27. This is 9. Okay, and here what is given? 6 to the power 4. Now this can be written as 6 square into 6 square. 6 square is nothing but 36. This is also 36. Now let us evaluate this value over here. Okay, 4 3s are 12 is given, or 3 2s are 6. This 6 will get cancelled. Right, you can evaluate on your own also. This value you can check. 4 2s are 8. This is 9 4s are 36. Okay, this is 2 into 18. You are getting 18 over here. Now you can evaluate 9 2s are this value. So what are you getting? 27 into 7 divided by 8 over here. So what is this value over here? That is nothing but I think 7 7s are 49. So this would be 189 by 8. That is option first would be the answer over here. So this is how you have to calculate coefficient of any term given in your exam. Let us move on to the next expression. So here what they are asking you, fourth term in the expansion. Very easy. T4 I want over here. Now what will you write? R plus 1. Be very careful. So R value should be 3 over here. R value should be 3. Now you can calculate what would be the formula. So they are asking you fourth term binomial formula. So 7C4. T4 over here. This will become 7C3 because R value would be 3 over here. Here you have to write Y to the power 7 minus 3. And next term is minus 1. Minus 1 to the power 3. You can evaluate this value. 7 into 6 into 5 divided by 6 over here. 3 factorial. I am writing 3 factorial. Because of that I have directly written this value. Y to the power 4 and minus 1 to the power 3. That is minus 1. I hope all of you are getting it. So this is nothing but minus 35 to the power y plus 4. So I wanted to tell you one more thing from this. Whenever you are expanding a minus b to the power n, please remember what will you get? nc0 a to the power n. Now second term when you are writing, you are going to get nc1. This will become a to the power n minus 1. And this is minus b to the power n. Means this will become minus b to the power 1. So this term will become negative over here. When you are talking about the second term nc2, this will become n minus 2 and minus b square. Now when you are writing the square, this term will become positive. So alternate you will be getting positive, negative, positive, negative. Remember first term would be positive and later on you have to make alternate value. Okay, first term has to be always positive. And then you make alternate value over here. So that is the thing I wanted to tell you using this negative expression, because that will be used in the question. So here again the same type of question, you can try this on your own. Coefficient of this value over here. So quickly let me write down TR plus 1 NCR A to the power N minus R, and second term is minus 2B to the power R over here. Now what will you write? You want A to the power 5 over here. A to the power 5, n value is 12. So 12 minus r is equal to 5, means r is equal to 7 over here. You can evaluate this value completely in this case. 12c7, a to the power 12 minus 7, that is 5, and minus 2b to the power 7 over here. So you can evaluate what is the value in this case. So this is how you have to solve the expansion. Now let me solve the next expression over here. Find the fourth term in the expansion. Again you can try this question. Fourth term means T4. This can be written as TR plus 1. So R value would be 3 over here. Write down the value 12C3. X to the power 12 minus 3. That is 9. And minus 2Y to the power same value, that is 3. So you can evaluate whatever value you are getting in this case. So I hope the concept has become more clear. These two questions you can figure out the final answer. Now let me move on to the next concept. So many times this can be asked in your exam. That is, what is the middle term of the expression? Now I told you there are n plus 1 terms. So when I am saying a plus b to the power 1, how many terms are there? 2 terms are there, right? So there is no, when I am talking about the even expression, let me take a plus b, whatever value. A plus B is equal to, suppose, next value, that is 3. How many terms would be there? 4 terms would be there, right? So let me write down T1, T2, T3, T4. Which one would be the middle term? There would not be middle term. There would be 2 middle terms over here. So whenever you have odd value, you are going to have 2 terms as the middle term. Same thing is written over here. Whenever you are expanding, if n value is even, so when I am talking about a plus b whole square, you know there are 3 terms. There are 3 terms. Which one would be middle now? Second one would be middle. Second one would be middle. So when n value is even over here, you can say 2 divided by 2. So n by 2 plus 1. You have to add 1 also over here. For example, when I am saying a plus b to the power 4, so 5 terms would be there. T1, T2, T3. So this T3 term would be middle. How will you get T3? 4 by 2 plus 1. Okay, so please remember this. N by 2 plus 1 term would be the middle term. Okay, when N value is even. Okay, and when N value is odd, there would be 2 middle terms. First one is n plus 1 by 2 and n plus 3 by 2 over here. Now, based on this, many time question would be asked based on this over here. Let me solve one question so that it will become more clear to you. So here they are asking you, what is the middle term in the expansion of this? Now, number of terms are even. I told you when even terms are there, middle term would be n by 2 plus 1. So what will you write over here? 8 by 2 plus 1 means fifth term would be middle. Fifth term. Now, when you are saying fifth term means T5. So when we are saying T5, we have to write TR plus 1. R value would be 4 over here. So you can write down the expansion for this. So how will you write this now? 8C4. First term is 1. 1 to the power 8 minus 4. And second term is minus x by 2 to the power 4 over here. You can calculate what is this value. 8, 7, 6 into 5 divided by this is nothing but 4, 3 into 2. Okay. Now this is nothing but 1 only. This is x to the power 4 because negative sign to the power even number will become positive only. So I'm not writing that. And divided by this value you can calculate, that is 16 over here. Now let us evaluate this value. 8 2s are, right? So this value also you can evaluate. 3 2s are 6. This will get cancelled over here. Okay, so what is remaining in this case? 35 upon 8 to the power x to the power 4. That is first option would be the correct one. I hope you must have understood now how to calculate the middle term. When you are given with odd term, you can calculate any one of these values as the answer. N plus 1 by 2 2th term or n plus 3. Both answers would be same. Okay, now let me tell you one more type of question that is asked in your exam. Many times they'll ask you to evaluate this value. Now 98 to the power 5, you cannot write down 98 into 98 like this for 5 times. It will become more tedious over here. Rather than that, you can use a binomial expression format in this case. How will you use that? So you can write this expression as 100 minus 2 to the power 5. Okay, now let me expand this. 100C0. Okay, so 100 to the power 5. Okay, and 2 to the power 0 would be there. Second term, let me evaluate over here. 100C1. So here you have to use negative expression formula. Keep that in mind. This will become 100 to the power 4. Okay, and next term is minus 2 to the power 1. Okay, similarly, when I'm talking about the third term, 100C2, this will become 100 to the power 5 minus 2 over here, that will become 3, and next value would be minus 2 to the power 2 over here. The sum should be 5. Okay, then fourth term would be 100C1. Yes, sorry, 100C3. You are increasing this 100 to the power 2 minus 2 to the power 3. And last term you have to write, that is nothing but, I think two more terms will be there, right? So 5 is there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 terms would be there. So 100C4, 100 to the power 100 to the power 5 minus 4, that is 1, and minus 2 to the power 4. And last term would be 100C5 and minus 2 to the power 5. So you can evaluate it this way. This way also it will become tedious. Such type of question will not be there. They'll again ask you coefficient only. But you should know that you can express it in these terms. Okay, let us move on to the next question. So here is where the application of this can be used. So which is the larger one? This is the question from your exam. Which is the larger value? This value or this value? I told you to give answer for this. You have to expand the binomial expression over here. Let me write it 1 plus 0.1 to the power 10,000. Can you write for few terms for this? So first value would be 10,000C0. That is nothing but 1. Anything C0 is nothing but 1. We have done this in combination. First term, that is 1 over here, to the power total value, that is 10,000. Let me write down second term, 10,000C1 over here. And this value is nothing but 1 to the power 9999. You have to subtract 1, so it will become 9099. And second term, that is 0.1 to the power 1. Are you getting it? Now like this, you have to expand. Now can you evaluate this term? This is 1, this will also be 1. Okay, let me evaluate this term as well. What is this value? 10,000 over here. What about this? Anything to the power 1. 1 you write any times, so you will get 1 only. and this point one will be written as it is. Few more terms are there. Let me evaluate this. This is 10,000 into 0.1 is nothing but 1,000 over here. You are getting first term is 1,001 plus I have to write other value as well. So who will be more? It is very much obvious using the first term, the second term. Okay, using first two terms itself, you can say that the first value would be more. So this is the application of this expansion over here. Okay, so no need to evaluate completely, but you can easily make out this thing. We'll do one more question. Now, okay, so here there is one more application of this. Now, in this type of question, they'll ask you, figure out how many terms are there. Okay, so the question would be like, how many terms would be there in the expansion? Now, here you should know the positive and negative expansion over here. So, when I'm writing the positive value, how many terms would be there? 5 terms. I told you first term is always positive. Second term would be negative. Third term would be positive. Then fourth term you can observe over here. It will be again negative. Fifth term would be positive. You know this. Now you have to. Sorry. All the values are positive. So let me write down all positives only over here. This is negative. So when negative value is there, you have to write down first term is positive. This is negative. Third would be positive. Fourth would be negative. And fifth would be positive. Can you observe this? Now minus is there. T1 would be cancelled because root 3 is same. Root 2 is also same. Okay, powers are also same. So T2 value, if you observe, it will become 2T2. T3 value will be cancelled, positive, negative. T4 would be again added, 2T4. T5 would be again cancelled. So there are only 2 terms in the expression. So your answer for the question would be 2 terms over here. You can evaluate those terms also. What would be the answer if I have to calculate T2? So T2 means TR plus 1. So R value would be 1 over here. So can we write down 2 times? What is R1? You have to write down 4C1. First term is nothing but root 3. Root 3 to the power 4 minus 1, that is 3. And second term is root 2 over here. Okay, to the power this value, that is 1. Getting it? Plus I have to write T4 over here. When I am saying T4, R value would be 3. R value would be 3. You can write down what would be the value over here. So 4C3. Right? Root 3 to the power 4 minus 3 is 1. And next value is root 2 to the power. You can write down the same value, that is 3 over here. Getting it? So this is how you have to evaluate. Now you can check whatever value you are getting. This is 4 only. This is written as root 3 cube. That is 3 root 3. And this is nothing but root 2 over here. Okay. Plus, what is this value? 4C3 is nothing but 4C4 minus 3. That is 1. So, again, it would be 4 only. This is root 3 value. This is 2 root 2. Now, you can multiply this. What will you get? 12 root 6. Plus, if you multiply this, this is 8 root 6. Now, in rational, when you are talking about irrational number, rational number you can directly add, but irrational number means when you have these roots, these two values should be same. Then only you can add it. If this is root 6 and root 2, you cannot add it. Here both are root 6. So I can directly add this. The answer would be 20 root 6. Okay. So you can calculate 20 root 6 would be the term over here, or this expression value would be 20 root 6. Okay. So two types of question can come. How many terms are there? And second one is what is the value? Okay, so use the positive negative formula accordingly. Now, this is the second type of question which can come in your exam based on binomial. For this, you need to remember one expression. Whenever a to the power n plus b to the power n is given and this n value is odd, n value is odd over here, it is always divisible by a plus b. The term is always divisible by a plus b. You can take example. For example, you might be knowing the formula for a cube plus b cube. What is the formula? A plus b, a square minus ab plus b square. I'm not bothered about this term, but I'm saying this term will always be there. Okay, so when you are saying a to the power 5 plus b to the power 5, similarly, this would be there. A plus b would be there. There would be other expression over here. Okay, so it is always divisible by a plus b. Similarly, when you are saying a to the power n minus b to the power n, it is always divisible by a minus b. When n is odd over here, It is always divisible by a minus b over here. So please keep this in mind. So observe, this is again an odd power. It will be exactly divisible by. So a minus b, so you have to write 49 minus 1, that is 48. First term would be 48. If 48 is there, means it will be divisible by 8. Are you getting it? It will be exactly divisible by 8. So only first term you have to remember, it will be a plus b or a minus b, depending on what your sign is given over here. So this type of question has also been asked in your exam. So I hope that is what I have for today. So I hope you must have understood the binomial topic over here. Please practice few more questions and stay tuned with us. Stay tuned with Audible. Thank you.